So I am originally from Nigeria, where I grew up and I lived for like 12 years of my life. It's funny because I hadn't even planned on coming here. I had taken exams to go to a school in my country, and my school, the high school I went to at that time, they offered opportunities for students to take the SAT. So I took that exam and I had my scores sent out to some schools, but I wasn't even really focusing on it. And then a few months later, I get an email from Hofstra telling me, oh, they like my SAT score and I should apply, and they're waiving my application fee, and it was really enticing. I wasn't really sure of what I wanted to do in high school, but I knew I loved the sciences, but I didn't know what exactly I wanted to specialize in. I spoke to one of my cousins who had gone to London to study, and she graduated with a bachelor's in geology, and I just asked her about it and what's it like, what it involves, and she got me really excited about it. So I came to school and I decided to try it out, and I just fell in love with it. When I first came, and it was really difficult for me to understand the accent, I would go through my classes and I'd be like, whoa, I don't understand. I need like someone to break it down slowly for me to assimilate. Now it's definitely better because I've interacted a lot with my friends and I understand the accent better. But before, I had to go in and spend like the extra time with my professors, and they were always willing to help me out, which was so amazing. So I am involved in a physical chemistry research with Dr. Sobel in the chemistry department. The research I'm doing involves a lot of mathematical modeling. So basically it's an oscillating chemical reaction. So it's a chemical reaction and it fluctuates, or it goes back and forth, repeats in circles. And we found that from literature that there are a lot of biological systems that follow this kind of pattern where they oscillate. Understanding how the reaction occurs would help us understand, oh, so what is controlling contraction, and if we sort of like increase this component, how's that gonna affect like contraction of the heart muscles or relaxation of the heart muscles, and how much blood will be delivered to the body. This January, I'm going to be involved in a study abroad to the Galapagos in Ecuador, and we're going to be looking at the biology and the geology of the area. So basically trying to tour and reconstruct everything that Charles Darwin did when he toured the Galapagos. I'm really looking forward to that. There's a lot of rich geology there. There's a lot of little like shield volcanoes and interesting geological features to look at. We're going to be going snorkeling. I've never snorkeled before, so I'm really excited about that and looking forward to it. I have a strong inclination towards working in the oil industry, at least for a start, and to get myself familiar with that and see if it's something I really like. So if I need to go to grad school for that, so I'm going to get my master's in either energy resources engineering or petroleum engineering, and then take it from there, see if I can get a job. I know like ultimately I really want to give back to my country, Nigeria, in one way or the other.